Welcome to Elite Golf Coaches Tip of the Month for June 2011. This month we're going to look at pitching, an important part of the game where a lot of the shots can be given away or retrieved. If you're a good pitcher of the golf course, the advantage you've got is you're never out of the game. You hit a few bad shots to the side of the green, you've still got that chance to make that up and down and grind out a score. It's very difficult to play against someone who's a very good chipper of the golf course, so they're never out of the game. That's one of the big factors. If you struggle with your pitching, suddenly when you miss that green, you're almost guaranteed to make a bogey or a double, and that has a real effect then on the pressure you're putting onto your second shots when you hit into the green. If you know you're not very good at that pitching, when you're hitting that shot into the green, the pressure's on to hit the target, and then that will affect the pressure, will affect the swings, and then tend to miss more greens. Miss more greens, make lefts up and down, so then you've got a bit of a vicious cycle going on there. So this month we're going to look at pitching, and just one particular part of it, the importance of getting the shaft in the correct position at waist height, and trying to feel that when you play with your pitching shot, that you're feeling your arms are doing more of the work. The wrists are a lot quieter than normal. What you find with people when they pitch, they try to sort of just let the club release, flick the hand of the ball forward, try to manipulate the ball up in the air. And the key thing with pitching is the loft is on the golf club already. Nowadays people use 52, 56, 60 degree wedges, they carry more and more wedges. So you've got the loft there. It's not like the olden days, you'd have one sound wedge, you'd be trying to open and close the club face and help add loft with your hands at impact. Nowadays, you carry more wedges, let the clubs do the work. The balls are so good, the clubs are so good, that you don't need to be flicking your hands now and trying to create the spin like you used to with the invention of the better balls and better golf clubs and new groove designs. So, what I'm going to work on with you, and it's one of the important factors we don't see with pitching, is getting the club in the correct position at waist height. What you see a lot of people do, and it's similar to one of the earlier tips of the month, we talked about the importance of getting the club on the line of the feet at waist height, and it's exactly the same with the pitching. That's what we're going to try to work on this month now, is to try to make sure, just because it's a shorter shot, it's just a shorter version of a normal golf shot. We're still trying to get that club to be nice on the line of your hands at waist height. Even sometimes a little bit outside the hands, okay? And you're trying to feel from that position there that you're just turning the body through it. Your wrists are staying nice and still, and you're turning the body. And the speed is coming from the turn of the body, the core of your body, as opposed to flicking your hands with it. If I add hands released into the golf shot, that flicking action, I'm creating speed. Now in the golf swing, that's great because you want a little bit of wrist release because that's just giving you the power. But in the short game, we're looking for control. We're not looking to hit the ball a long way. We're looking to get consistency of strike and also consistency of distance. So if I take out that anomaly of my wrist hinge, okay, and I just replace that with my shoulder turn, the club is now much quieter. I can control the speed now because the speed is just coming from one area, which is my body, as opposed to if I add my hands, you can see now I push faster that club moving and creating more speed. And I take that out and I just use my body turn. Okay, my wrists are staying a lot stiller, they're relaxed, but they're still. Okay? Now from that position, what we're going to work on here now is on a little preset, that set up, at waist height, we're trying to get that club nicely on the line of the feet there, okay? Nice and neutral. Leading edge towards the sky. Same difference here as before, using the shoulders, the wrists are staying nice and passive, I'm just turning my body back and getting that club nicely on the line of my feet. Then from that position, I'm going to feel my body turning through again. My wrist staying nice and still. You'll notice my palm is slightly longer than what I just did back, and that's to show I've accelerated through the golf ball. What you find with a lot of people is the club tends to get wrapped around their body when they pitch. They use their wrists way too much, and they flick the club behind the golf ball, and what you'll see now is the club will be manipulated. You're moving around a massive amount. And it's very difficult to hit the ball straight when the club is only squaring up from a fraction of a second. So it's key now this month when you go to practice and you work on your pitching, just like we worked on in the past, the backswing with a normal golf shot, getting the club on the line of the feet, but we do exactly the same when we pitch, okay? It's a shorter version of it. We work on it, you look at the old tips for the month, the setup, the narrow stance weight on the left side. You can look at that for the importance of the setup. But in the actual swing itself, we're still trying to get those same basics. Wrists nice and still, turning the body back to waist height so the club is on the line of the feet. Leading edge or the bottom of the club is up to the sky, and then from there, we turn the body through the shot, and the wrists are staying nice and still. Really, really important. Try and work on that this week now. Go down the range, hit a few baskets of balls or down the practice area, and work on getting that club in a nice neutral position at waist height. So the club is on the line of your toes, the leading edge towards the sky, and then from that position, you're feeling your body turning through the shot. Your wrists are staying nice and still, and the speed is coming from the body. I think you'll find if you work on that, you'll see a big difference in one, how much strength that you start the ball towards the target, the club will be on a neutral angle, way back on the line of your feet, but more importantly, how much better your distance control becomes when you take out that wrist release. So remember, less wrist, more control of the pitching. I hope that helps you, and we'll see you for next month's Tip of the Month.